If an electron spin is aligned along an external magnetic field, the spin precesses around the field lines. When applying a cyclic disturbance, in the form of a time-oscillating magnetic field perpendicular to the first field, the opening angle of the spin precession can be increased at the appropriate frequency, and finally the spin can even flip, i.e. change its orientation. This so-called electron spin resonance is first demonstrated in two preparatory experiments and then in a regular experiment. Today, electron spin resonance, ESR, is mainly used for the analysis of crystal structures, chemical reactions, and other problems in all branches of science. It also enables the determination of the Lhondey factor. In a first mechanical preparatory experiment, a large gyroscope, which is mounted on a mandrel with almost no friction, is manually set in rotation. The gyroscope is located in the Earth's gravitational field of gravity, which acts on the center of gravity of the gyroscope and exerts a torque at the center of rotation. As a result, the gyroscope performs a precession movement with a frequency nu. If a cyclic disturbance is now exerted perpendicular to the gravitational field in the form of a small blow with the finger against the axis of rotation, the opening angle of the precession movement can be increased if the phase and frequency nu of the disturbance are well chosen. In extreme cases, the gyro can even tip over. A further preparatory experiment with magnetic forces can be carried out with an air-bearing ball. The sphere has a cylindrical bore in which a permanent magnet with red and green marked poles is located. Around the sphere, four magnetic coils are arranged on a plate in such a way that their axes intersect at a right angle at the center of the sphere. As soon as a direct current is applied to the two vertically opposite coils, a corresponding magnetic field B0, constant in time, is generated. The bar magnet in the sphere, and thus the entire sphere, align parallel to this magnetic field. The magnetic moment of the permanent magnet points parallel to the magnetic field B0. Now, the plate is tilted at an angle by a mechanism of a support leg. Due to the Magnus effect, the ball starts rotating, with the bar magnet or the axis of the B0 magnetic field forming the axis of rotation. The plate is tilted back to the horizontal position, whereby the rotational movement remains unchanged. Due to small imperfections in the geometry of the sphere or small disturbances in the airflow, the axis of rotation of the sphere rotates relative to the direction of the B0 magnetic field. As a result, the ball performs a weak precessional movement with a frequency nu, analogous to the gyro described after the first impact. Now, a second current is passed through the two remaining coils, whose direction can be reversed manually by a switch. This generates a low frequency alternating magnetic field B1, which is perpendicular to the constant magnetic field B0. The alternating field only influences the precession movement of the ball if it also has the frequency nu. Analogous to the gyro, this leads to a widening of the angle between the axis of rotation and the magnetic field axis, until finally the axis of rotation flips over, analogous to the change in the orientation of the spin. The magnetic moment of the ball now has a different orientation relative to the constant magnetic field B0. For this reason, the state has a higher potential energy, which was supplied by the alternating current circuit. For the experiment of electron spin resonance, a temporally constant, homogeneous magnetic field B0 is generated by a Helmholtz coil pair. The magnetic field B1, which is perpendicular to this pair and oscillates harmoniously in time, is generated by a small resonance coil. The potential energy required to change the electron orientation relative to the B0 magnetic field is supplied by an oscillating circuit and the resonance coil. When a sample in the form of a small glass tube is pushed into the resonance coil, the variation in the strength of B0 allows the spin to be measured. In this process, energy is taken from the oscillating circuit. This results in a fluctuation of the voltage applied to the resonance coil, which can be visualized with the help of an oscillograph. If the sample is removed, the resonance signal disappears immediately. If the sample is pushed into the resonance coil, the resonance signal is immediately visible again. For technical reasons, in contrast to the two preparatory experiments, the frequency nu of the alternating field B1 is set here in the range 15 MHz to 100 MHz and then kept constant. The sample with the substance 1,1-diphenyl-2-picryl-hydrazil, or DPPH for short, a white powder, is placed in a glass tube and pushed into the resonance coil. Then, the current 2I running through the two Helmholtz coils, and thus the strength of the magnetic field B0, which is constant in time, is readjusted until a symmetrical resonance signal is observed in the oscillograph. First, some frequencies nu of the alternating field B1 are set, and the current 2I necessary for resonance through the Helmholtz coil pair is determined. We choose nu equals 40 MHz and find 2I equals 0.74 amps. We choose nu equals 50 MHz and find 2I equals 0.91 amps. We choose nu equals 60 MHz and find 2I equals 1.08 amps. These and other measurements yield the following table. Electron spin resonance, or ESR for short, is based on the cancellation of the degeneration of energy levels in an external field, as can also be observed in the Zeeman effect. The spin of a free electron, and thus its magnetic moment, has two possible orientations in an external magnetic field B0, parallel or antiparallel. The possible components of the magnetic moment in the direction of the magnetic field are mu s equals plus minus 1 over 2 g s times mu b. The alignment of the spin can be described by the magnetic quantum number m s, which can thus assume the values m s equals plus minus 1 over 2. Analogous to a bar magnet in a magnetic field, which is oriented once parallel and once antiparallel, these states have two different potential energies. The potential energies can be described using the magnetic quantum number 2 E put equals G S times mu B times absolute value of B0. The corresponding energy diagram is shown. To change the orientation of the spin in the magnetic field, energy must be supplied. The required energy is calculated with ms equals plus minus 1 over 2 to delta E equals gs times mu b times absolute value of B0. The transitions can be introduced by an alternating magnetic field with a frequency nu equals delta E over h, which is oriented perpendicular to the constant magnetic field B0. This leads to the resonance condition with the form delta E equals h times nu equals gs times mu b times absolute value of B0. The description can be used not only for free electrons, but also for a paramagnetic atom. We look at our measurement series. The magnetic field B0 of Helmholtz coils can be calculated from the current I through each coil as B0 equals mu 0 times 4 over 5 to 3 over 2 times n over r times I, with mu 0 equals 4 pi times 10 to the minus 7 volt seconds per ampere meter, and the winding number n equals 320, and the radius of the Helmholtz coils r equals 6.8 centimeters. Entering the values for the magnetic field B0 of the Helmholtz coils in the table of measured values yields for 40 MHz 1.57 millitesla, for 50 MHz 1.92 millitesla, and for 60 MHz 2.28 millitesla. This is shown graphically in the following diagram. Fitting a straight line to the observed linear relationship, one obtains the gradient nu over B0 equals 27.44 megahertz over millitesla. This yields the G factor of the sample. G equals h times nu over mu b times B0 equals 6.625 times 10 to the minus 34 watt second squared over 9.273 times 10 to the minus 24 amps meter squared times 27.44 megahertz over millitesla, which then equals 1.96. In comparison, the literature value of the G factor for dPPH is G equals 2.0036. dPPH is an organic compound and a relatively stable free radical that has an unpaired valence electron at one atom of the nitrogen bridge. Therefore, the dPPH molecule has a G factor which is almost equal to that of a free electron. Result: electron spin resonance, ESR, is an important method for studying molecular and crystal structures, chemical reactions, and other problems in physics, chemistry, biology, and medicine. It is based on the absorption of high-frequency electromagnetic radiation by paramagnetic materials in an external magnetic field in which the spin states of the electrons split.